Let's talk about drawing Lewis structures. So most textbooks are a little bit convoluted in that they try to oversimplify the rules, and you end up running into situations where you can't actually draw a Lewis structure, or they try to be so precise and their language isn't clear, and you end up going down rabbit trails. So I've tried to distill these rules for drawing Lewis structures as simply as I can. And again, the best way to do Lewis structures eventually is just to do examples until you get the hang of it. And so we've got four of those at the end of this video to help. So first rule, we need to count the valence electrons in all of our atoms. And so we know group 1, group 2, group 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The group number of the main group elements just tells us what the valence electrons are. The D block and the F block only have two valence electrons, the ones that arise from the main group, okay, from the outer shell. Because remember, when you're counting, the 4s is here, row 4, but this is the 3d row, okay, so it's inner shell electrons, not valence. Okay, that's an aside. We won't be running into many transition metals in this discussion of Lewis structures. So just the main group elements are what we are primarily concerned with, and their numbers of electrons that we'll get here. Okay, so the next rule, and again, correcting for polyatomic ions, we'll talk about with an example. We want to connect the central atom to outer atoms with a single bond, and the central atom is going to be the least electronegative. So if we know that fluorine is the most electronegative element, and electronegativity increases up and to the right, so the farthest away from fluorine is going to be our central atom. Also, if there's only one type of atom, that's going to be the central atom. Or if it's carbon, in an organic compound, carbon loves to be the central atom at all times. After we connected our outer atoms to the central atom with a single bond, we're going to fill the valences of our outer atoms, noting that H cannot get lone pairs and that the others will get a full octet. We want to put any leftover electrons on the central atom, and if the central atom does not have an octet after this step, we'll use multibonds to do this. And to do that, we're converting a lone pair into a multibond. Okay? Minimize formal charges if possible during this step. Then finally, we'll add the formal charges to our Lewis structure. So a lot of rules, but it's best to just put those into practice. Okay, so let's do our example. The first one, CCl4. So as you learn dot structures for a reason, because they loosely get you to a Lewis structure. If we take four chlorines, which have a dot structure with seven valence, one unpaired, a carbon with four unpaired, if you had four chlorines, you could envision pairing up the electrons in dot structures to get our full octet onto carbon and share the electrons. So we're beyond this now. We are now at the point to where we can do Lewis structures and get rid of all the dots, okay? And so that's what we're gonna do. Let's start with our rules. Count the number of valence electrons. Carbon and four chlorines give us four from column four, 4 times 7, 28 plus 4, 32 total electrons in this molecule. Connect to the central atom. Carbon loves to be the central atom. It also is the most electropositive of the two. So we connect with a single bond. Then we fill the valences of the outer atoms. 2, 4, 6. The bond counts as 2, so it's now got 8. Octet, 2, 4, 6, 8. Already have 2, 2, 4. 6, 8, all of these are the same. Now we look, 8 times, we have 8, 8, 8, and 8, so 8 times 4 is 32. We're out of electrons, and so we're done with this Lewis structure. Okay, formal charge, if we look at the formula for formal charge, it's the number of valence minus the number of bonds minus the number of dots from the lone pairs on the element. So if we look at chlorine's normally 7. It's got one bond and 6 dots, formal charge of 0. If you do the same calculation for carbon, you'll have 4 valence minus 4 bonds, 0 dots, is still 0 formal charge. So we're done with this Lewis structure. Okay, let's look at the next example. This is perchlorate, polyatomic ion, perchlorate. Let's count the electrons. Rule number 1, 1 chlorine, 4 oxygens, correct for ionic charge, negative 1. Okay, so we've got to correct for the number of electrons that have been added based on the charge correction. So I always show that as an electron correction. Okay, and so 7, 4 times 6 for oxygen, and 1 extra electron for the negative charge. There'd be a negative 1 there if it were a positive charge. So 24 plus 25 plus 1 is 25 plus 7 is 32 electrons. Central atom, least electronegative, is chlorine. Connect to the outer atoms, 4 oxygens. Fill the valences of the outer. And when we count, we get 32, so we're done. Now we have to put formal charge in. Each oxygen, if you do the calculation, has a negative 1 formal charge. 6 minus 1 bond is 5, minus 6 dots is negative 1. Okay, so negative there. Chlorine likes to have 7 valence, so 7 minus 4 bonds is plus 3. Plus 3 minus 4 is negative 1, so the total charge, there are 4 negative 1s and a positive 3, that's a total of negative 1, so we have balanced out here and we are good. I do not do expanded octet. Okay, if your book tries to get you to do so on a problem, you're free to do that, but I will accept either with expanded octet or without. I don't think it's necessary because I think it's more confusing than we get out of it. We can still get all the information we need without the controversial expanded octet. Even the textbooks can't agree on whether it actually exists. Okay, so we're going to stay with this structure, and we'll see with molecular structure it's a tetrahedral structure, just like expanded octet would predict. Okay, all right, so we're done there. Let's try two more. How about SOCl2? So count them up. No charge. Sulfur 6, oxygen is 6, chlorine is 7. So 14 plus 6, there's 20 plus 6 is 26 electrons. And the least electronegative is sulfur. Connect to the outer atoms. Anywhere we want to place the oxygen versus a chlorine is fine, but we have to fill the octets of the outer. And so now we are at 24 electrons. Okay, and so 24 electrons, 8, 8, 8, okay, we need two more. They go on the central atom and that completes the octet of sulfur, 2, 4, 6, 8 now. So if we do formal charge, we have a negative 1 here, a positive 1 on the sulfur, and we are done with our Lewis structure. What about formaldehyde? Okay, so we've got C, two H's, and an oxygen. Carbon has 4 valence, hydrogen has 1 in group 1, oxygen has 6, so 6 plus 2 is 8, plus 4 is 12 electrons. Central atom, carbon trumps everything. Connect one single bond to every outer atom. Fill the valences. Well, hydrogen only gets 2 from rule 1. Okay, or rule 2. Okay, so only gets 2, so it's done. It doesn't get any lone pairs. Oxygen gets an octet. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. So we're out of electrons with carbon. Does not have an octet. It only has 6 electrons from 3 bonds. 3 times 2 is 6. two electrons in every bond, two in every lone pair. So we've got to give multibonds to carbon by converting a lone pair on oxygen into a double bond to carbon. When we do that, we get this structure. It has no formal charge on any atom, and we are done.